Good morning, Mustangs. Today we have news on the school musical.
They got spirit dance.
And much, much more. I'm Haley Hummel.
And I'm Karina Wancha. And welcome back to
your Mustang Morning News. Today we're on double assembly schedule, and tonight is also the God Spirit Dance. The dance starts at 8 p.m. and ends at 10. Tickets are free with ASB and $20 without. All demerits must be cleared to attend. Don't forget to bring your ID and wear your God Spirit shirt. Can't wait to see you there. Have fun, Mustangs!
Last night was opening night for the school musical, Cinderella. Congratulations to all who performed and put time into this musical. The show was amazing. If you are interested in seeing the show, they will also be performing on the 26th, 28th, and 29th, all at 7 p.m. Make sure to go see the show.
Join the Tribeca Hills PTSA for the Create with Kindness program. At this meeting, you and your family get to talking about digital kindness. The meeting is on April 26th from 7 to 8 p.m. in the NPR.
Yearbook is looking for new students that are interested in exploring the skills of design, photography, and writing. If you are interested in contributing to the school, join Yearbook. If you join, you have the opportunity for a discounted yearbook, have a discounted senior ad, and work towards Cal State/UC credits. Make sure to reach out if interested.
Our annual Juniors vs. Seniors Powder Puff game is coming up on May 11th at 7 p.m. in the stadium. We look forward to the game. Good luck, girls!
The Tribeca Hills High School Chamber Choir and Auroras recently returned back from the Hawaii State Heritage Festival with a sweeping success after competing against some of the most recognized school choir ensembles from across the country. Both Mustang ensembles not only earned gold rankings and won their various categories, but also shared the honor and title of festival champion. This put our choirs in the top 10% of the country, earning their fourth invitation to sing at Carnegie Hall. Great job, Mustangs!
Also, please be mindful of the impact you have on the cleanliness of our beautiful campus. If you're eating food, make sure to throw it away in any trash can placed around campus instead of throwing it on the ground. Make sure to keep the bathrooms clean so others can use it. Our custodial staff works extremely hard every day to keep our campus clean, and we greatly appreciate all the work they do for us. Thank you, custodial staff, and be mindful and considerate, Mustangs.
Well, that's all we have for today, Mustangs. We hope you have a great weekend.
Make sure to follow us on Instagram at THHS Morning News for more.
And as always,
happy birthday and go blue!
The year is 1928, and you're on your way to high school. When you get there, the teacher tells the class they'll be listening to something on the radio. People are ecstatic, since radio is nationally adored, and never showed up in the classroom. They played a special radio segment called the Standard School Broadcast, and it was the first time schools used a digital media source for their news. So how did we get from this...
The Standard School Broadcast.
To this.
Good morning, Mustangs!
Today we have news on the off-the-wall latest production,
info on grad night,
and much, much more.
This is the history of student broadcast. Well, while the film industry had begun in the 1920s for America, schools didn't pick it up until the 1930s. Until then, colleges across the country would see the rise of the campus radio station. In fact, the first campus radio station was established in 1912 by Penn State University. These student-run radio stations were the first example of campus-wide digital storytelling and newscasting. High school students had to wait for this technology and got their radio stations by 1940. Of course, student radio stations are still quite popular today and employed in around 800 schools around the United States. Film schools began to emerge around this time, and soon after, high schools began incorporating film classes into their curriculum. Schools had been using film to document things since around the 1900s, but student-for-student content wasn't present until the 1980s. For example, El Toro High School created a video yearbook for their seniors in 1985, and Tribeca created one in 1990. A few years later, in 1999, the Student Television Network, or STN, was established with the stated goal of supporting and encouraging scholastic broadcasting in high schools and middle schools. STN holds yearly conventions that inspire students to improve their own student broadcasting programs. Additionally, the Academy of Scholastic Broadcasting was established 1 year later, in 2000, and educated teachers on how to run their own student broadcast classes. Nowadays, these programs teach students in them how to operate in the film industry and inform the entire campus of valuable information that would otherwise be difficult to get out. Over the course of around 100 years, the student broadcast world has evolved incredibly and now exists within many schools all over the country.